Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another problem with the normal line. And in this one we've been given the function y equals x squared. And we've been asked to find the normal line of this curve at the point negative 2, 4. So the normal line is interesting. We know about the tangent line already, right? So for example, we've got the curve y equals x squared. So that looks something roughly like this, y equals x squared. They're looking for the point negative 2, 4. So let's say that's roughly right about here at negative 2, 4. We know that the tangent line is going to run like this close to the graph, and it's going to skim the graph and intersect it only at the point negative 2, 4. So the tangent line is going to run that way. The normal line is the line that is perpendicular to the tangent line. So in other words, at a 90 degree angle from the tangent line. So this would be the normal line to the curve at the point negative 2, 4. And we've been asked to find the equation of that normal line. So the way that we do it, the first thing we're going to do is go ahead and line up our equation, y equals x squared, with this formula here for f of x. So we're going to say y equals x squared, and we're just going to line up our terms like this, right? So since we have x squared here, we're going to line it up like this. And the reason I'm doing it this way is because we want to know, in our case, what p and q and r, what the values of those three variables are. If you know already how to use derivatives to find the slope derivative of y equals x squared, which will give you the slope of the tangent line, then you can go ahead and do it that way. Otherwise, we can line things up like this. But if we do this, we can see that equating our function to the formula f of x means that p has to be 1, right? Because there's no coefficient on our x squared. So since the formula has px squared, we know that p has to be 1 in order for these things to be equal. It also means that we have 0 for q, right, 0x, and 0 for r, because in our function, this whole qx and r term don't exist, which means we've got to have 0 here. So that means that p is equal to 1, that q is equal to 0, and that r is equal to 0. And the reason we care is because we now want to take this information and plug it in to the equation that'll give us the slope of our tangent line. So notice we have p and q in this equation. Let's go ahead and find m of x. M of x will be equal to 2 times p, which we already found was 1, times x plus q, which we already know is 0. So when we simplify this, you can see that we just get 2x. So that means that 2x is going to be the slope of the tangent line. Well, we're most concerned with the slope of the tangent line at the point negative 2, 4. So we plug in the point negative 2, 4 to m. So let's do this. M of negative 2, 4 would be 2 times negative 2, which will give us a negative 4, right? We take this point here and we plug in negative 2 for x here, and we get negative 4 as the slope of our tangent line. So now we can use the fact that we have the slope here and the point p, we can use that information to write the equation of our tangent line in slope-intercept form. So we're going to say y equals the slope, which is negative 4, times x plus b. Remember that the slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. Then we can plug in the point negative 2, 4. We plug in 4 for y and negative 2 for x, and we want to solve for b. So we'd get 4 equals positive 8 plus b. Subtracting 8 from both sides, we get negative 4 equals b, which means the equation of our tangent line is y equals negative 4x minus 4. So we just took our answer for B and plugged it back in up here. So negative 4x minus 4. And if we want to write that in point-slope form, if your problem asks for point-slope form, remember that's y minus y sub 0 equals m slope times x minus x sub 0. So we would write y minus 4 equals the slope, which is negative 4, times x minus a negative 2 would be plus 2. So that would be point-slope form of the equation of the tangent line. So now that we have the equation of the tangent line, we can go ahead and write the equation for the normal line, which is what our problem asks for. So we need to take the slope, which we already know is negative 4, right? And we plugged it in to the tangent line here, negative 4. Our slope is negative 4 for the tangent line. Well, since the normal line is perpendicular to the tangent line, we know that the slope is going to be the negative reciprocal of the slope of the tangent line, meaning that we multiply the slope of the tangent line by negative 1 and then flip it upside down. So here's what I mean. We've got negative 4 as the slope of the tangent line. If we multiply it by negative 1, then obviously we're going to get positive 4. And then flip it upside down by putting it in the denominator of a fraction with 1 in the numerator. So if the slope is negative 4 for the tangent line, the slope of the normal line is going to be positive 1/4. If the slope of the tangent line was, let's say, positive 1/2, we would multiply it by negative 1 and we would get negative 1/2. And then we would flip it upside down and we would get negative 2. So that's how you can convert the slope of the tangent line to find the slope of the normal line. So in our case, the slope of the normal line is positive 1/4. So we, again, can write in slope-intercept form or in point-slope form. Let's do slope-intercept first. It would be y equals 1/4 x plus b. We just plug in our slope. Then we plug in our point again, because all three of these lines are passing through the point, right? The curve, y equals x squared, this curve passes through the point 2/4, the tangent line passes through the point 2/4, and the normal line passed through the point 2/4. So we can plug in the point to find any of them. So 4 equals 1/4 times negative 2 plus b. And then if we solve this, we get 4 equals 1/4 times negative 2 is a negative 1/2 plus b. Multiply through by, well, actually, let's just add 1/2, which would be 4 1/2 or 9/2 is what we would get for b. So we can write the equation of the normal line in slope-intercept form as y equals 1/4 x plus 9/2. And if we need to write it in point-slope form, then we can write it as y minus 4 equals 1/4 times x plus 2. So either way, both of those things are exactly the same, but you've got the slope-intercept form for the equation of the normal line and the point-slope form for the equation of the normal line. So that's it. I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!